Now in this part, we'll study about insulators and conductors. Substances can be divided into two categories. One is of conductor and other is of insulators. Conductors, the substances through which the charges can flow easily are called as the conductors. Like metals are good conductors of electricity. Metals like silver, copper, aluminium, these are all good conductors of electricity. Even our human body is also a good conductor of electricity. Now come non-metal. This is an exception. Non-metals are not good conductors, but graphite, a form of carbon, is a good conductor. Now coming to insulators, the charges cannot flow easily through them. For example, rubber, glass, paper, charges cannot flow through them easily. So these are known as the insulator. So in short, we can say the substances through which charges can flow easily are conductors, and through which it cannot flow easily is known as the insulators. Charges we can consider over here to be the electrons also, ions also. Now coming to the electricity. Electricity again can be divided over here into two forms, static electricity and current electricity. Static means when the body is at rest. So when the electricity is at rest means the charges are not moving, they are in rest. We call it to be static electricity. For example, if you take a plastic ruler and rub it through dry hair and bring it next to the pieces of paper, we'll see that the plastic ruler is going to attract the pieces of the paper. This is known as static electricity. The electricity is not moving through the piece of that plastic ruler. Instead, if you take a metal ruler, the charges will not be retained on that. You cannot retain the charge on the surface of the body of a metal ruler. This can be done only in plastic, which is an insulator. Now coming to the current electricity. The electricity which run through the wires at your home is current electricity. Over here, the free flowing electrons are flowing through the wire, and this is known as current electricity, where the charges can move easily. Now coming to the next topic, that is electric potential. What is electric potential? It is a work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to that point in an electric field. Of any charge. Now see, this is the electric field of any charge. Suppose if I bring a charge, a unit positive charge, from infinity means from a distance very far away from this electric field. If I am bringing a charge from here, that is from infinity, to a point inside the electric field of any charge, then the work what I am doing in moving the charge from infinity to a point inside the electric field will be my electric potential, will be called as my electric potential. The work which I am doing to move a unit positive charge from infinity to a point inside the electric field of a charge. Now, what is electric field? Electric field is the area around a charge in which its force can be experienced is known as the electric field of that charge. Suppose I am placing a charge over here. So, the area around this charge in which its influence or force can be experienced by any other charge if you place, then this much of the area around it will be called as its electric field. Now moving to the potential difference. As the word suggests, difference means between 2 points, two places or two quantities. So over here, amount of work done in moving a unit charge from one point to the other point is known as potential difference. Now suppose we have moved a charge from infinity to a point over here, say A, and now we are moving the charge from point A to point B within the field. So the difference between the potential of these two points will be called as the potential difference. Again, I am repeating, if I am moving a charge from infinity to a point A inside the electric field of a charge is called electric potential. Now if I move a charge from A point to point B within the field, then the difference in the potential of these two points will be called as the potential difference, and it will be given by the formula potential difference equals to work done upon quantity of charge. Now coming to the next one, V equals to W. This formula can be written by like this: V equals to W upon Q. The SI unit of potential is volt. Volt can be given as 1 volt equals to 1 joule upon 1 coulomb by the formula. See, work done can be measured in joules and charge is measured in coulomb. So 1 volt can also be written as 1 joule upon 1 coulomb. Now electric potential can be measured by an instrument known as voltmeter. See over here, voltmeter. Voltmeter is always connected in parallel. It is always in parallel to any circuit. See, we are supposing these two points of a circuit where this is a conductor over here. So I am connecting this parallel to the circuit. See, voltmeter is connected parallel to the circuit. Voltmeter is always of high resistance so that it takes negligible amount of current from the circuit. Now we will be seeing a numerical over here. How much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulombs from a point 118 volt to a point 128 volt? The numerical says if you are moving a charge from one point to another, one point is having this much volt, other is having this much of volt. If you are moving a charge between these two points, how much work you are doing? So by the formula itself, potential difference equals to work done upon charge. Potential difference will be 128 minus 118, that is equals to 10 volts. So work done will be given as potential difference into charge. 10 potential difference to your charge. So 10 into 2, 20 joules. 20 joule will be the answer. Okay children, in the next series I'll be bringing assignment, a small assignment on potential difference for you and electric current.